Hey guys, and welcome back to the Gerbil Vine. If you're new here, make sure you hit that like and subscribe button so that you never miss our uploads. Today's video topic is going to be different ways to set up your gerbil home. If you haven't seen my other videos, let me begin by stating that I firmly believe that gerbils should be housed in nothing smaller than a 40-gallon. If you have to temporarily house your gerbils in something smaller than a 40-gallon tank, I think that that's fine. It's just not something that I recommend keeping gerbils in as a long-term housing solution. You want a solid home that gerbils cannot chew through that still provides adequate space and ventilation for them. In my opinion, tanks are just ideal in every type of way for gerbils. They are tall and long, so they provide a good burrowing depth and length, and they are relatively escape-proof as gerbils can't chew through glass. So a basic 40-gallon tank is a perfect starting place for your gerbil's habitat. In the wild, gerbils live multiple feet underground, which protects them from the weather and from predators. I have noticed a lot of people under the misconception that gerbils are a desert species of animal, which is incorrect. Gerbils are actually a semi-desert species of animal. Desert species are forced to survive on little to no rain in a mainly harsh and barren environment. Semi-desert species of animals actually get about 20 inches of rain per year. While they also live in a dry climate, they at least have grass and shrubbery growing nearby. Gerbils don't dig their burrows in sand in the middle of the Sahara Desert. Instead, they choose to make their burrows in mountainsides, grasslands, and in steeps. In their natural environment, gerbils will sometimes begin to dig their burrows beside plants so that they can use the roots to help stabilize their tunnel systems. Based on this information, it proves extremely challenging to attempt to recreate a gerbil's natural environment while they are our pets. The best we can do for them is to give them a large home with a bunch of items that we think will help them live a long and happy life. There are many things that you can do to make the optimal setup for your gerbils, and I really do love cleaning day so much because I always have so many ideas and inspiration on just how I'm going to set up the tank next. Now, there are many different ways that you can set up your gerbil tank. You don't have to simply just dump in a massive bag of bedding. You really can get quite creative with your setups and see what works best for your gerbils and what's super enriching for them and maybe what works best for you. I've set my gerbil tanks up many different ways, including like this. Now, this way of setting up a gerbil tank is not the traditional way that you usually see. Here, I've placed a 10-gallon tank inside of my 40-gallon tank and filled it to the brim with bedding. I then have a bunch of rocks and wood pieces along the ground, with the substrate being loose coconut soil and hay. There are also two ways in and out of the smaller tank. I've set up my tank like this on a couple different occasions, and if I'm being honest, I didn't notice much change in the gerbils' behavior, other than they seem to like being out and exploring more. When gerbils have a ton of bedding, you sometimes won't see them all that often, as they are busy exploring, building, and just having fun underground. And while I don't recommend always keeping your tank like this, it can be fun to switch it up every now and then for their enjoyment, and for yours too. I found that my gerbils really enjoyed having the extra space to forage, play, and climb, so it's nice to give them more of an enriching environment from time to time. I by no means recommend housing a gerbil in a 10-gallon tank, but placed inside of a 40-gallon tank could offer them a smaller, deeper bedding area and a larger play area. Then we have the more traditional and commonly seen gerbil setup, where you have a ton of deep bedding and some sort of divider in a more shallow area for the wheel, water, and sand bath. This is a great way to give your gerbils the most burrowing space, but still have an area for them to play and clean themselves. A lot of owners use bendy bridges or cardboard as a divider because gerbils are such strong diggers and bedding tends to fly all over the place. In the first couple photos here, you can see that almost 2/3 of their tank is for burrowing, with 1/3 being for their wheel and sand area. They have some bendy bridge dividers to hold back the bedding, and they have a moss bridge leading from the bedding into their sand bath. This is likely the most commonly seen way of setting up a gerbil tank, and one that works well for owners who aren't super handy and into DIY projects. While this way of setting up the tank worked really well for a while, I did find it to be a bit of a pain, as I constantly had to go in and tidy up the shallower side, so I just ended up making a platform. Using a platform in my tank was a game changer. I made my platform 10 inches tall and was able to provide the gerbils with a decent amount of bedding for burrowing and have their sand, dig pot, and water all remain free of bedding. Having a platform is awesome for the tank. It helps to keep it more organized, and it's really, really cool because you can place it anywhere in your tank without compromising on their floor space. My platform is completely hollow underneath, So the gerbils have the full area underneath it to nest and continue making their amazing tunnels. Once you have a platform, I don't think you'll ever go back to life without one. Having a platform allows you to set up the tank in such cool ways and ultimately gives the gerbils more burrowing depth and length, and in my own opinion, makes the tank look prettier. As you can see in the photos here, my tank looks more organized, less messy, less cluttered, and overall more aesthetically pleasing. The final appropriate way to set up your gerbil tank would be to use a topper. This was something that I had wanted to do since I basically got my gerbils, and I'm so happy that I was finally able to build one, with some help from my husband, of course. My topper is basically the same size as my tank, give or take an inch or two. So the gerbils are able to have the entire 40-gallon filled up with bedding at about 17 inches tall. In the 40-gallon tank, they have a full deep bedding area. Underneath that is multiple hidey houses, chew toys, cardboard pieces mixed in, and some natural tunnels. They've also got natural wood branches and a platform with their 11-inch rodent wheel, and a large oak tree root, a moss bridge, and a large rock leading them up into their topper. In their topper, they have some wood, some hanging chew toys, their sand, on occasion their dig pot, and their water bottle and bowl. This is hands down, no going back, my preferred method of keeping gerbils, and in the future, I don't see myself ever using just a regular tank again. So the last example of appropriate gerbil home setups we're going to be looking at today is actually from a subscriber who is extremely passionate about gerbil housing. Her name is Lav, and her habitat is a 100 centimeter by 60 centimeter or 39 by 23 inch tank. You guys, that equals out to almost 900 square inches of floor space, which she mentions is the Living World Eco Habitat with a topper that is 100 by 55 centimeters or 39 by 21 inches. That is a hamster cage she bought on eBay. That's actually quite close sizing there. I really love that. I did the exact same thing with my own topper recently. So I think this tank looks absolutely awesome. And she says here that she modded everything together to be chew and spill proof, which is even more amazing. She has two platforms and one holds a mini 3-gallon aquarium filled with sand, which we can see over here. And it's got this cute little ramp in it. And another one for food and interacting with her gerbil. She has an 11-inch wooden wheel, which is really great. And some really nice hanging cork tunnels and an adorable little nameplate so you know who lives there. And then look at all of that bedding. There's so many different textures here, paper, wood, hay. It looks absolutely amazing. She mentions underneath all that bedding is a house and two sand blasted vines. This lucky gerbil has the entire tank to burrow with 19 inches of total bedding. This is a perfect example of a gerbil owner going above and beyond for their pet. This tank is absolutely massive. There is a ton of bedding in there, there's a ton of enrichment, and there is even an above recommended size wheel in there. So thank you to Lav for all the creative DIY work that you have put into making your gerbil's home absolutely perfect. Anyone watching this video can clearly see how much care and dedication you have put into what you describe as your biggest passion. So thanks for watching. I hope you all learned something, or maybe you've been inspired about all the different ways that you can set up your gerbil tank, whether you choose to use a divider, if you use a platform, or if you use a topper. As long as the gerbil's needs are put first, that's all that really matters. You don't have to spend a ton of money on this type of stuff either. I did mention in my previous video that I spent about $20 to make my platform. As always, don't forget to like and subscribe so that you get notified every time we upload our new videos. Thank you. Bye.